Hi everyone, welcome with another vlog. This video was taken on a weekend. In here, I'm showing some recipes based on request and some other. Hope you would like it. Keep watching. I was preparing vellappam the next day. On my Instagram, I had shown on my story about preparing vellappam without yeast, and many of you wanted to see the recipe for it. And much thanks to whoever had given me tips to prepare. Now that's white rice. I'm taking 2 cups and soaking for at least 4 hours. So this was done in the afternoon the previous day. Then around 6 in the evening, I made the batter as the rice had well soaked. Adding half the rice in the grinder. Then goes 3 tablespoons of cooked rice. This is ponni rice that I cooked for lunch. Then fresh coconut, around 4 tablespoons. Some water and grind well. Then the rest half of the rice. Here I'm taking 2 tablespoons of cooked rice. Then 3 to 4 tablespoons of fresh coconut again, some water and grind. Batter shouldn't be neither too thick nor too thin. Now I wash my hands and mixing it. This is what I felt the tip to get a good vellappam. Same thing I do with idli and dosa batters too, and I get very good results. So tried vellappam too and it came out well. Keeping it for fermenting till morning. It depends on your climate conditions too. It's all fermented now. These happen when I do in fast mode. I'm transferring to another bowl to add salt into what was needed on that day. My little Spider-Man. These are my iron kadais. Now I had 2 guests coming for lunch, so it was a busy day. That's why keeping 2 kadais for preparing the appam, so that it becomes a little faster. Otherwise I usually keep only 1. Just spread some oil onto it. Add a big spoon and swirl. I'm keeping on low medium flame. Meantime, I'm keeping some water to boil, that's for the rice for lunch. Keep the lid open for few minutes before taking it off. You can see the appam is ready. In between just washing the rice for lunch, we have again switched to ponni rice just to have a change. I had already drained and kept it ready so that I could add it as soon as the water boils. That's a simple coconut chutney getting ready on the other side. Shall post a link below or on the iCard above for the coconut chutney recipe. Milk for tea. You can see the box has come out from its position. I had stuck it with glue gun earlier, it came out again. Now these vegetables we had bought just the previous day, so I didn't organize it well. It was still in the cover just because I would be using the next day. I'm preparing my mother-in-law's sambar without any packet sambar powder. I had shown this once in my Kerala vlog. I wanted to get the measurements once more. It was really sweet from mom to get the recipe written on a paper and she sent the photo of it and a voice note too. Keeping all the vegetables in water for some time. Rice is ready. Now this is dried red chilies. Using this for some recipes you will see on the go. Washing it well. Then soaking in hot water for some time. That's filtered water that I had boiled. Breakfast time. This was previous day fish curry. It tastes heaven the next day and that too with vellappam. I usually eat from the pot in which the curry was prepared to get the complete flavor of the curry. I have the recipe in one of my vlogs. Shall link it again above or below in the description. Now many had doubts regarding my fridge organization, where I would keep the leftovers. I had already mentioned in the beginning of that video, all fridge arrangements are not the same. I have very less leftovers at home because I always prefer to cook on a daily basis unless on a lazy day when we eat out. My leftovers are mostly a small bowl of curry or just a spoon of any dish. Or same this way, if any batters are left, I could keep it in a tiffin that would fit at the very top part of my fridge. And reheating will never give the same taste, so I always try to cook daily new dishes. Some of you wanted to know how I clean the clay pots. I just add little dishwash liquid and lightly scrub the pot and then clean it. I don't know if there's any other way. If you know, please comment below so that it would be helpful for me and others too. And keeping your jar shiny, I once in a week, or maybe when I have some food particles stuck inside the jar and it wouldn't come off, just add some dishwashing liquid into the jar along with some water. Cover the lid and on your grinder just for a few seconds, or pulse it at least one or two times and it becomes very clean and shiny. Once the sink is all clean, moving on to cleaning the chicken. This is around 1.5 to 2 kg chicken pieces. I'm frying the chicken, so just cutting it into smaller pieces. washing the lady's finger or the okra. Soaking some tamarind in water, that's for the sambar. I'm marinating the chicken first, so adding some soaked dried red chilies. I'm using some water from this to grind. Few pieces of ginger. Some garlic cloves, some shallots. A handful of curry leaves. Then goes 2 tablespoons of fresh coconut. Now this is optional, but it gives a good flavor and taste to the fry. To this add turmeric powder, around 1 or 2 teaspoons, half teaspoon garam masala, some salt. Now you can add pepper powder, cumin powder, coriander leaves just to enhance the flavor. I'm keeping it very simple. Let that get marinated till frying. Washing a cup of dal for the sambar. Add some water and cook. Meantime, chopping all the vegetables. Now, when I'm in a hurry, I clean the drumsticks this way. This is not exactly how it's done, just to speed up. That's raw plantain, string beans, you can chop it small or long, it's up to you, carrot, one onion cut into large pieces. I'm using a large clay pot here in which I will be preparing the sambar. Add some water and start cooking. I'm chopping up the okra to make another dish, that's pachadi we call. I have cut into this size. I have kept some aside, chopped in bigger size. This is for the sambar. Heating a kadai. Adding some coconut oil. I'm frying this first in the oil till I get rid of the stickiness or the gluey kind of thing from the okra. Keeping this aside till I need it. In the same oil, adding 1 heap teaspoon of mustard seeds, let it splutter. Meanwhile, the veggies are half cooked, so adding the fried okra and 1 large tomato chopped or sliced, whatever. Mix well till everything is well cooked. Once the mustard seeds are spluttered, adding a handful of curry leaves. Then go to chopped okra. Let it get fried well. That's a soaked tamarind. Squeeze it well and add to the vegetables. Mix and let it boil for a few minutes and then off the flame. Onto another vessel, adding coconut oil. This is for making the coconut paste for the curry. You will need enough oil for getting a good taste. That's Chana Dal, some Urad Dal, Tuvar Dal, just a mix. Then methi or fenugreek seeds, cumin seeds, mustard seeds. Mix for a few seconds. All the measurements again are given below in the description box. Then whole coriander seeds, you will need quite enough. Some dried red chilies. Once everything is fried for a minute, add around 1/2 to 3/4 cup of grated coconut. Some black pepper powder and roast well till the coconut is a little crisp, but don't burn it. Finally adding hing or asafoetida and roast for 1 minute and take it off. Then let it cool down. The okra is almost done, so making a paste to add in it. Into a grinder, 3 tablespoons of fresh grated coconut. Usually green chilies are added, but I had these soaked red chilies left, so I'm adding this around 9 to 10. You can add more or less. Then a teaspoon of cumin seeds and grind well. Add this to the okra and mix well for 5 to 6 minutes. When it's done, take it out into a bowl so that it cools down before adding to the curd. Meanwhile, just getting ready to fry the chicken, so heating the kadai. While that's getting heated, grinding the coconut for the sambar. I'm adding 1/2 the cooked dal along with it. You can add full if it fits in your grinder, or you can skip it and add straight into the vegetables. I grinded the rest of the dal along with enough water and adding it. The oil here is heated, so I off the flame and added some curry leaves. And then on the flame again. The curry leaves gives a good flavor to the oil. Again. Some salt. Now this has to boil well for at least 5 minutes on medium flame. Make sure it doesn't burn at the bottom. Into another bowl, adding around 1 cup curd or yogurt. Just beat it well with a fork or spoon. Then add the okra prepared. Check the salt and add. Mix everything well. That's the seasoning for the sambar with mustard seeds, curry leaves and dried red chilies in coconut oil. Now my husband was getting the table ready, so I was adding each into bowls. Now many had doubts why I don't invite ladies and children for food. It's nothing like that. I do have friends and families who come over for food, only that I hadn't filmed that day. Some may be comfortable, some may not. In fact, I had done few recipe videos when they were at home. Next time shall show my lady friends too. Now when they were having food, I made an instant dessert because I couldn't find the necessary items I wanted for making a pudding from the previous day shopping. Into a bowl, I added half tin of condensed milk just to check the sweetness, but I added full later. Then a cup of cream cheese and around 100 grams of fresh cream. Then the other half of condensed milk. Whisk everything well. Then into a glass tray, first I layered some store-bought cakes where we get that cream filled cakes. You can go for any. Then later I crumbled everything as a first layer. Then the cream mix. Again some cake pieces. You can add nuts for a crunch. I made it instantly just to serve them quick. You can get my recipe similar to this on the above icard. I always eat my lunch when I finish serving my guests and they are settled. Only then I could relax and enjoy my food. I don't like sambar much. In fact, I like only fish curry. Otherwise, I wouldn't add any curry to rice. It's really very odd to show my kitchen this way, but this is reality and I like to clean and arrange it neat all my own. If at all I call my husband, he would be happy to help, but since he was with a guest, I didn't do so. Storing this cream in a glass jar and to be kept in the refrigerator. Nothing is more satisfying for me than a clean kitchen. My mother used to keep telling me a house is clean when the kitchen and the toilets are shining. I guess that's true because these are the two places that gets dirty very fast. Later evening, my husband had gone for playing. Rehan had already gone for coaching. Just checking out Arman's school homework. Then I got a video call from my brothers, and that's always a refreshing one for me. Just for a kick from the stress, I wanted to have a small cup of coffee. That's instant coffee powder, very less water, and then beat well. If you don't have this beater, you can use a spoon and mix very hard till your coffee powder becomes creamy. That's a little workout, so this is easy. Then adding hot water, some milk. Just to give a light flavor, I sprinkle some cocoa powder or any chocolate drink powder on top. When all were asleep, I had midnight craving for something sweet, and it happens sometimes. So I chopped up a banana, added some nuts and the sweet cream. So that ends today's video. Hope you enjoyed watching it. Do try out the recipes and I would love to hear your feedback. See you soon with another video. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.